Megan Fitzmartin and Laura Braga explore how some previous young heroes are dealing with the death of the Justice League as Superboy, Impulse, and Robin are all whisked away to the past by an unknown force, and Wonder Girl is the only one who can save them. Megan Fitzmartin takes the reins of Young Justice and explores how the former members of the hero team are dealing with grief and the deaths of their mentors. While I appreciate the book for utilizing these characters and giving them an interesting time travel adventure, the attitudes of many of the cast, specifically Cassie being as she's the POV character, seems kind of mean and bitter. I understand everyone grieves in different ways and they have a right to be upset, but it's the way that it's presented that I wasn't really a fan of. The characters seem so resentful that they have had to grow up and that their mentors have had other partners after them, and partners who are also now getting the spotlight, like John becoming Superman, Damian becoming Robin, and Wally becoming the Flash. I'd be fine with it if this was a story from 15 years ago, but these heroes have had mentors and friends die so many times over the years that a story about them being bitter and resentful now feels kind of out of place. The back half of the issue with the time travel stuff and the return of Mighty Endowed, a villain who uses her boobs to hypnotize people, was hilarious and so out of left field and wasn't something I expected in the comic, yet here we are, and I thought it was quite fun, and I'm intrigued to see what they're going to do with that time travel aspect. Laura Braga's artwork for the issue was fantastic and captured the history and emotions of Young Justice well. I love the return of the 90s era costumes for the team as well, specifically the Robin costume of that era, which has always been a favourite of mine, and it always has looked brilliant, and here is no different. Dark Crisis Young Justice issue 1 was a real mixed bag. On one hand, you've got characters acting a bit out of character and getting extremely bitter and resentful about their place in the world now, and on the other hand, you've got the beginning of what looks to be a cool time travel story, kind of doing a greatest hits of the Young Justice. Maybe a little bit more plot progression will help crack the story of these characters' emotions open more, but we'll have to wait and see. I'm going to give this issue a 6.5 out of 10. Dark Crisis Young Justice issue 1 finds the heroes of the world gathered at the vigil for the fallen Justice League. Cassie Sandspark knows that the last few years have felt like one long parade of funerals, and first Hippolyta died and now this. She knows this time the funeral is more personal, as Wonder Woman is gone now and Diana was much more than a mentor to her, since she protected and guided her to become the hero she is. She knows that she and her friends are all alone now, since they are the children of the dead, but they don't get to grieve like children, wondering where this leaves herself, Connor Kent, Tim Drake, and Bart Allen, the heroes who used to be Young Justice. Earlier, the group constructs the giant gold statues out front of the Hall of Justice, as Cassie knows that something will go wrong, and during every crisis, it's spelled trouble for their community. She remembers how Impulse fought Superboy Prime and got lost in the Speed Force, grew old, became the Flash, and was murdered a few months later. Connor was killed by Superboy Prime, and it broke their hearts, but also led to Cassie and Tim finding a romance. Something Cassie hopes Connor never finds out about. Cassie and the others meet in the hall, and Arrowette apologizes for not being in touch more since college applications are keeping her busy. She wonders when they were all together last, told by Bart that it was when Connor came back, as Cassie remembers that they used to spend all of their time together, but now they are all living lives outside of each other and they are too afraid to tell each other what they are thinking. Bart wonders if they will get this type of treatment when they die in battle, but Connor knows they didn't the last time they died. Cassie wants to strangle the boys for talking like that, as she heads off with Sissy, who notices that Cassie looks like she's going to destroy something. Cassie says that Diana died and they are all in the same room now, pretending that the last few years never happened, wishing some of them had actually stayed dead. Suddenly, Superboy, Impulse, and Robin disappear altogether from the hall, making the heroes wonder where they went. Elsewhere, Tim is awoken by Alfred telling him that he's getting a Young Justice alert. Tim wonders how he's even alive, making Alfred know that he must have been having a terrible dream, wanting to fetch the Robin suit for him. Superboy meanwhile awakens in Hawaii, finding Doublex isn't too pleased the boy fell asleep during another of his briefings. Connor thinks that he's dead again, but Doublex says that the briefing can wait since Young Justice is needed. Bart meanwhile finds himself training with Wally and Max Mercury, getting hit by the punching bag. Wally tells him to be careful since he's not fast enough, since his brain doesn't move as quick as his feet and he needs to move in tandem with his enemy. Bart thanks Max for helping him up, but he knows he has known this stuff for years and knew when they lost Barry, but he doesn't need to go so hard on him. Max and Wally, however, know that Bart has never met Barry Allen, as Bart remembers these drills were from when he was younger, before Barry came back to life. Impulse wonders where he is, speeding off around America to find out which heroes are alive and active, finding Kyle Rayner to be the only Green Lantern, as well as Connor Hawke being the new Green Arrow. Impulse heads to Happy Harbor, where he finds Connor and Tim at their old Young Justice HQ. Bart thinks that they have traveled back in time or in a world where everyone else is backwards, but Connor thinks that maybe they are back to how things should be. Tim thinks that Bart is right, as he can't find any information or history past Superman's death in 1993. He is reminded of the alert they got, reminding Bart that someone is in trouble, so it sounds like a job for Young Justice. Back in present day, Cassie tells Arrowette that they can't find the boys anywhere. Sissy says she hasn't seen them, frustrating Cassie since she isn't helping, but she reminds Wonder Girl that she isn't a hero anymore and she is out of the hero life. She thinks the boys are probably off finding a coping mechanism to process their fake dads being dead. She leaves, telling Cassie that they'll be fine since they always are. Superboy, Robin, and Impulse meanwhile find the crater with someone in it. And Impulse thinks this area feels familiar, and Superboy agrees as the mighty Endowed reveals herself, intending on defeating the heroes. The boys remember this weird fight, knowing not enough therapy in the world will help them as Endowed attacks. In the present day Flash Museum, Wally coordinates with the other speedsters about the rampant crime as Cassie arrives, wondering if any of them have seen Bart. Wally apologizes since they are swamped with crime and hopes that she is there to help them protect Central City. Cassie pleads with Wally, telling him that she doesn't think the boys are on the planet anymore and she is afraid something has happened to them. She asks if he's not even worried for Bart, but Wally knows that he doesn't have time for teen angst and Bart will grieve however he needs to, and if he's with Connor and Tim, it's the best thing for him. Cassie heads to Bloodhaven and Metropolis to ask Nightwing and Superman for help, but they haven't seen Connor or Tim either, thinking that they are off grieving in their own way and they'll come back when they are ready. Cassie doesn't know why her generation of heroes seems to get hit with all of the crises, since it's exhausting and they are meant to deal with it on their own like it's no problem. Young Justice meanwhile battle Mighty Endowed, with Superboy stopping the villain from using her cleavage hypnosis on his friends. The woman says she must kill Young Justice, as Robin knows she's not really a threat. This angers the woman, who throws Impulse and Superboy away before smashing Robin in the face. The boys regroup, remembering this villain was never this intense when they originally fought her. Superboy knows that someone is coming to their rescue, as in the present, Cassie wonders if her wishing the boys were dead did this. She knows that they are somewhere out there and friendship isn't easy, least of all theirs, but at least it's their own. She knows she's going to find them, as in the past, Wonder Girl arrives and bests Mighty Endowed, saving Young Justice.